Please stand for the salute to the flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What is up, Kumpf Cougars? Today is Wednesday, January 7th, 2015. I'm Josh Hill.
And I'm Luke Gilner. And it's time for KTV Live, Bon Appetit.
So how do you feel that this show is going to be twice as good because we didn't have a show yesterday?
I think it's going to be fantastic, Josh.
As do I.
I say we just get right into it right now.
Like right now. Let's right go. Now. January 1st marked the start of the year 2015, and StatisticBrain.com states that about 50% of Americans have made New Year's resolution. I know my New Year's resolution is... Okay, here we go. StatisticBrain.com also states that the number one New Year's resolution is to lose weight.
Seventh grader, if you had Mr. Serby during marking periods 1 or 2, and you are interested in being a full-time member of the KTV Live morning broadcast team, there is a meeting today. The meeting will take place after school in room 23. See Mr. Serby if you have any questions or submit an application early.
This video is not like any other video you have witnessed. Let's check this out. This video is to the actual YouTube video that had shown a resemblance to the YouTube video Weapon of Your Choice, starring Christopher Walken.
Well, on the Kumpf Infinity blog, a reporter, Gianna D, talked about Mr. Hoos beginning floor hockey in gym for marking period 2. What was one penalty Mr. Hoos discussed, according to her report? Is it A, high stick penalty? Maybe B, a yellow card? Possibly C, technical foul? When talking about this penalty, according to the blog report, Mr. Hoos stated, "Oh, I'm sorry, here's your eyeball back." And the answer is A, high stick penalty. Gianna D also stated, "Mr. Hoos makes hockey fun, safe, and educational." Mr. Hoos also discussed rules, regulations, and skills of hockey.
So, Rock, you gonna inform me on sports?
Yes, I will. So, last night in hockey, the Devils beat the Sabres 4-1.
That's great, Emma.
Yeah, and it was a big day for Patrick Elias as he scored his 1,000th career point.
That's actually a really good accomplishment. I don't think too many people do that.
Nope. And also, the Sharks beat the Wild in a nail-biting overtime game, 4-3.
That's pretty close, yeah.
Yeah, and lastly, the Blues beat the Coyotes 6-0, and David Backes scored 4 of those goals.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, had a good game.
All right, well, I'll see you later, Rocky.
This week is Mexican Food Week. One dish that is always thought of when talking of Mexican food are tacos.
Tacos are a classic Mexican dish that date back to the 1500s. I will be teaching you how to make this delicious treat.
To make these tacos, you will need a taco shell, beef, lettuce, cheese, and tomatoes. Grab a plate and have the ingredients around you. First things first, you have to put the beef in the taco shell. Make sure you evenly distribute the beef throughout the entire taco shell to taste the beef in every bite. Next, you must put lettuce on top of the beef in the shell. Lettuce is an important part of every taco and the most healthy ingredient. After that, sprinkle the shredded cheese on top of the lettuce you just put on. Lastly, add the tomatoes to the almost finished taco. This is what a finished taco should somewhat look like.
Tacos can be served with beef, chicken, steak, or pork. Reporting for KTV, I'm the one and only Luke Kilmer.
In 2012, Americans alone devoured 4.5 billion tacos.
Today's KTV holiday is National Old Rock Day. According to HolidayInsights.com, they say Old Rock Day is an opportunity to enjoy and appreciate old rocks and fossils. Perhaps you can start a rock collection. This holiday has been around for about 20 years, according to HolidayInsights.com. So now we're here to go see what Emily has to say.
I'm interested in what she has to say. Let's see it.
All right.
Okay, so I have a flyer for the Woodbridge Community Center Winter Fun 2015, and they have mini golf, roller skating, ice skating, a bungee trampoline, and many more, and it's half-price admission if you have the little coupon on this, so let's pass it back to you guys.
Half-price admission?
That's crazy.
I got to cash in on that deal.
I got to check that out.
Maybe I'll do it after the show.
Yes. Yes, we will. Mexico is a large country that is located in North America. What fictional creature is Mexico most known for? Is it A, the chupacabra, maybe B, the Sasquatch, or even C, the Yeti? This creature is said to resemble a dog or wolf, and the answer is A, el chupacabra. According to skeptic.com, el chupacabra is an animal unknown to science and a systematic killing machine in places like Mexico. It is said that the chupacabra's eyes can paralyze and hypnotize others' eyes. The chupacabra's main diet is goats and farm animals.
There will be a mandatory Odyssey of the Mind meeting after school in room 2 from 3 to 4 p.m.
So you're going to inform me on this weather outside?
You bet I am. And it is looking really snowy outside, as you can see by the whiteness outside. And today will be partly sunny with a high of about only 23. And tomorrow will be mostly snowy. And tomorrow it will be 24. And tomorrow will be 22. And on Friday, it'll be 32 and snowy, and on Saturday, it'll be 25 and sunny.
I don't mind this snow, so I'm okay with this weather.
All right, it's just a little cold.
Check up with you later.
Mr. Acosta is a guidance counselor at Comp for students with last names starting from A to L.
I became a guidance counselor because I used to be a phys ed teacher, and I was a phys ed teacher for about close to 15 years. And while I was a phys ed teacher, many students came to me asking for my advice. They came to me with problems that they're having with their friends, problems at home, and I was always there for them. You know, even though the school had a guidance counselor there, some of the kids just felt very comfortable talking to me. So I said to myself, you know something? As much as I love phys ed, let me give counseling a try. So I went back to school. I got my master's degree in counseling, school counseling. There was a
Sorry about those technical difficulties, but Mr. Acosta and Ms. Giannucci want all students to see them if they have any problems whatsoever.
The Comfinfinity blog is having a meeting next Tuesday. We are especially looking for new bloggers who are experts on sports, school clubs, mobile apps, and video games. The meeting is Tuesday after school in room 23. So, for even more KTV news, subscribe to us on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and Facebook. For Luke Giltner and the rest of the KTV News team, I'm Josh Hill. Have a splendid day.